We just reached almost 122 decibels, which is incredibly loud. But how loud would something have to be to physically move you? In the video game Skyrim, there are powerful shouts that can be used against other characters, and one in particular that blasts them away. What would happen if you were on the receiving end of that shout? What if you were Fusro Da? Starting from the bottom of the decibel chart, 0 dB is the sound of a mosquito 10 feet away. 65 dB is about the level of me speaking to you right now. Then we get to 100, which is a normal car stereo at maximum volume. And since decibels are on a logarithmic scale, 100 dB is actually 10 billion times more powerful than 0 dB. At 145, your vision starts to vibrate. After 165, your eardrums will just rupture. And once we get to 195 dB, we no longer have a sound wave, we have a shock wave. A shock wave or blast wave can cause a considerable amount of internal damage without causing any external physical damage. After air raids in World War II, there would be casualties with no wounds or any sort of marks. It wasn't until the autopsies when doctors noticed that their internal organs were destroyed. To actually propel you into the air, the shout would have to have the equivalent of a high explosive that you are only a few feet away from. The intense rise of pressure and heat would blow you backwards, and that blast wave would ripple through your body, rupturing your lungs, scorching your skin, and as it transfers through different parts of you, going from bones to tissue, your limbs become incredibly susceptible to being ripped off. In fact, you wouldn't even hear the final word in Fusro Da, since the shock wave would blow out your eardrums before the sound could even carry. And after you skid across the ground to a stop, take solace in knowing that due to Newton's law of motion, that every action has an equal and opposite reaction, your attacker is dead as well. But a sonic boom or a shockwave doesn't have to be because of a huge explosion. What you hear when a whip cracks is the tip of the whip breaking the sound barrier. Even a trombone can create a shockwave. But let's get ridiculously loud and turn the volume up to 1100 decibels. At 1100 dB, it is the equivalent to 10 to the 98th watts of power, which, if it lasted for only 1/10 of a second, would produce around the same amount of energy as the largest nuclear bomb ever detonated, times 47. Quinvigentillion. In this great paper by Professor David Boulderstone, he talks about the Death Star destroying Earth and calculates it would take 53.7 sextillion tons of TNT to annihilate the planet, which is quite a lot less than 1,100 decibels would produce. If someone shouted at you with that much energy density, it might not blow you away, it might actually pull you in. Because that shout just created a black hole. According to NASA, the estimated mass energy of the universe is 4 times 10 to the 69th joules, which is considerably smaller than the energy made by this 1100 decibel shout. Taking that immense energy and converting it to mass gives us 1.113 times 10 to the 80th kilograms, which would mean the radius of the event horizon of this Fusro Da black hole would be 1.747 times 10 to the 37th light years, or larger than the diameter of the observable universe. It would spread at the speed of light, devouring Earth, our solar system, the galaxy, and then the universe. So a normal Fusro Da would kill you and be a suicide mission for the person shouting, but an incredibly large one would bring you and your attacker as close together as possible, in a singularity. And as always, thanks for watching.